continue. We've had a number of requests, but we're going to sing another song anyway. We want to dedicate this to our baritone, Bill Carpenter, because in this particular song, Bill's girlfriend is mentioned 3 times. And we sing for you now, tramp, tramp, tramp.
this gone? Is this still on?
Well, yeah, I got thinking back there. You know, I talked to Jerry here. I told him that that earlier in the week that I had heard a story at work, and he said if I didn't take too much time, that I should probably pass it on to the folks. Do you think it'd be all right?
Oh, good. Thank you.
I want you folks to picture this. It's the third grade class in school, and it happens to be the teacher's birthday, and a few of the little kiddies in the class have brought a present for their favorite teacher, you see. Well, now little Mary comes up there, and I got to explain her father happens to own the local, he's a florist down at the florist. And her present is quite obviously from the florist. It's a vase. A rack wrapped with green paper up around the flowers and tied with a little yellow ribbon at the top. Well, the teacher plays along with this. She says, "Why, Mary, could this be a stuffed toy?" "No, teacher." "Could this be a giant lollipop?" "No, teacher." Well, she opens it up, and it's a fresh floral, fresh from the florist. Then comes up little Bobby, and again, I've got to explain that Bobby's father happens to be a baker at the bakery. And his present is quite obviously from the bakery. It's a little box wrapped with white paper and tied with string. So again, the teacher plays along with this, and she says, "Why, Bobby, could this be Crayolas?" "No, teacher." "Could this be writing paper?" "No, teacher." Well, she opens it up, and it is four fresh chocolate eclairs, fresh from the bakery. Got them rolling now, don't they? Then comes up Glenn. Now Glenn's father happens to own the local tavern and liquor store down in the corner, and Glenn comes up there with his little brown paper bag and kind of plunks it on the teacher's desk, and there's a little liquid oozing out of the bottom, so she goes to take a taste, and she says, "Why, Glenn, could this be Kool-Aid?" "No, teacher." "Could this be lemonade?" "No, teacher." "It's a puppy."
Jogging. Of course, back then they called it desertion.